Okay, let's talk about the thrust required. Okay, so let's consider an aircraft flying through the air, and let's draw a free body diagram. Okay, so our airplane's going to look something like this. Okay. So here we have an aircraft with the wing and the tail, and it's flying through the air with velocity V. And it's flying parallel to the Earth. Okay, so let's draw a line here to represent the velocity vector. Okay. Now let's label the forces on this aircraft. So if we'll well first let's I'm going to label these in blue. Okay, so let's start out with the weight because that's easy. All right, so the weight acts through the center of gravity straight down toward the center of the Earth. Okay, now if you'll recall from aerodynamics, the lift acts perpendicular to the direction of the air or the velocity vector, and the drag acts parallel to the free stream velocity vector. Okay, so in that case, the lift would act straight up, and the drag is going to act straight back. Okay. So here we have the weight, the lift, and the drag. Now, before we label the thrust, let's look at another important line on the aircraft. I'm going to do this one in yellow. Okay. So, if we take the aircraft from the tail to the tip, and imagine there's a straight line drawn through there that represents the orientation of the aircraft, we're going to call this the fuselage reference line. Okay. And the angle of attack is measured from the fuselage reference line to the velocity vector. Okay, so that's going to be this angle. Now, obviously, this is a very exaggerated angle of attack. All right, and in general, I'm going to do exaggerated angles here so that you get the picture. Okay, so let's go to the thrust then. So the thrust is actually generally aligned, or not aligned with the fuselage reference line, I should say. So here's our thrust. We're going to call it T sub R. Okay. And then the angle from that to the velocity is what's known as the thrust angle, or alpha sub T. Okay. Now, generally, alpha sub T is very small. Okay. Angle of attack is small, and alpha sub T, the thrust angle, is also small. And we're going to use that approximation later on, but for now, let's just leave it where it's at. Okay, so what we're concerned about here in this section is the thrust required to maintain steady level flight. And what is steady level flight? Well, there's two parts to it. There's steady and there's level. Steady, what that means is that it's unaccelerated flight. Or, in other words, the sum of all the forces in all the directions is equal to zero. And level means that we're not at any climb angle, so no climb and no bank angle. Okay, so this is like about the simplest flight condition we can have. And we want to figure out the thrust required to maintain steady level flight. Okay, so I'm going to switch colors to green now to do some analysis here. So let's leave our free body diagram here and let's look at the forces. Okay, so let's sum the forces. So if we sum the forces in the direction of the velocity, the x direction we'll say, we find that drag equals TR cosine alpha T. And if we do now the vertical direction. Find that lift equals weight minus TR sine of alpha T. Okay? So, as I said, what we're concerned about here is the thrust required to maintain steady level flight. So if we look at these two equations, we can see that if our thrust is greater than the thrust required, or I'm going to put this over here, or T is greater than TR, well then our the thrust times the cosine of alpha T is greater than the drag, and so we will begin to accelerate. And the same is true for the lift equation, right? If we have more thrust than what's here, then our lift will be greater than our weight minus, excuse me, our lift will be less than our weight minus, if we have more thrust than the thrust required, then we will begin to climb, I guess. We'll have more force in the vertical positive, we'll begin to climb. If our thrust is less than our thrust required, then the opposite's going to happen. We're going to decelerate, and we will also descend. Okay? So, if we take a look at the lift and the drag, for convenience, we can define the lift to drag ratio. Okay, we can put these together so that we can solve for the thrust required. And when we put these together, we get that the lift to drag ratio is W minus TR sine of alpha T divided by TR cosine of alpha T. Okay, and then we can, from this equation, solve for the thrust required. And that's going to look like this. So let's, we have TR cosine of alpha T times L over D equals W minus TR sine of alpha T. Move the screen down a little bit. So then we'll have TR L over D cosine alpha T plus sine of alpha T equals W. And then finally, we can bring all this in parentheses down below the weight, and we end up with TR equals W divided by L over D cosine alpha T plus sine of alpha T. And there we have an expression for the thrust required. And you'll notice that this thrust required is a function of the weight and the lift to drag ratio. Now, just a quick note, it's common for us to assume that the thrust angle is very small or close to zero, okay? And if we do that, if we assume that alpha T is approximately, it's approximately zero, then we can rewrite this. Well, what this implies then is that sine of alpha T is zero, and that cosine of alpha T is one. And if we plug that back into our expression for the thrust required, let's say for alpha T approximately zero, then the thrust required is the weight divided by the lift to drag ratio. Okay? And then if we take that a step further and say for steady level flight, we can simplify it more. And the way we do that is I'm going to go back and up to the lift and the drag. Okay? So if we look at the lift and the drag right here, let's assume that the thrust angle is zero. If we do that, then we can cancel off this entire portion here, because this is zero, and then we can take this off as well because that's one. And so then what we find is that drag is approximately equal to TR, and lift is approximately equal to weight. So this is for the small thrust angle approximation. Okay, so if we bring that back down here, we have lift approximately equal to weight. And so then this and this cancel out, and we have TR equals drag, which is exactly the same as what we derived for the drag, right? Now, in this course, a lot of this course, we're going to be using the small thrust angle approximation, but I want to, at least with thrust required, I wanted to show that we can do it with the approximation or without, and the process is the same. So just to review, we talked about this before, but we start out with a free body diagram. We've derived an equation for the thrust required. And so now we can describe the thrust required as a function of some other parameters. And we find that the thrust required is a function of the weight and the lift to drag ratio if the thrust angle is not close to zero. And that if the thrust angle is close to zero, then the thrust required is very nearly equal to the drag.